is going to be doing reverse lunges or backward steps using the actual step. So the step height that I've chosen this week is 2 bricks under each side. This can be lowered to accommodate people's different bodies and different needs. So if there's any knee issues or any other sort of challenges, perhaps they might be new to exercise, I would highly recommend to go down lower, either 1 brick or just a platform on its own. So we're starting off by standing on the step and we're facing this way. So the step is going to be lengthwise, you're stepping off backwards. When I set my class up, I actually have my whole class with the step this way and then half of the class facing into the center of the room on each side. It's much easier for me to monitor technique and for them to also see what I'm doing myself. So I often refer to front leg and back leg. So starting on the step, you're going to be stepping backwards. So step back, drop down, come up, feet together. Now you'll notice I stay in a slightly bent knee position. Back, down, up, in. Back, down, up, in. Now, the reason why I stay slightly bent is to keep my body from pushing off into an upright position. This is what it looks like. What you'll find is that your clients will create this like almost whiplash action using their head to thrust themselves forwards. If you keep the knees bent on the step, they won't do it. So, step back, knees bent, gives them much more control. That's it. Then, a variation of this is to just perform it on one side only. So, same thing, coming up, out, coming up. Another variation is to go back and stay here and do 3, 2, 1, feet together. Back, 3, 2, 1, feet together. Now, this other leg that's on top of the step should be getting a fairly good burn, but it's mainly quads. So then we can play around with that. We step back and we drop down 1, up, back, up, back, feet together. Step back, up, back, up, back, feet together. So you can play around with some of those exercises to give a bit more of a balanced challenge. Alternatively, you can step back, lift, back, lift, back, feet together. Back, lift, back, lift, back, feet together, and already I'm starting to get quite fatigued in the opposite leg. From there, you probably will change legs. I'm not a big fan of just absolutely killing one side and then doing the other side, because I think that when people build up too much fatigue, the technique starts to fail. And they start using their head, they use their arms to create the momentum to perform the exercise. So if you are seeing that there's been a bit too much fatigue, pull it back, go to the other side. Just be smart about it, because it's not about thrashing your clients so they can't walk the next day. Then we do some balance exercises. So from here, just reaching back, tapping the floor with the toe, using the arms for balance. Now, just showing you front on, you want to look for that the knees going in the same direction as the toes, but also the hip. So when you're dropping down, you're not seeing this hip move out to the side. This is when I'll start to get lower back pain as well. So ideally keep the hip in a straight line. You can do all sorts of things. You can ask people to place their hands on the hips to feel how much they're shifting. It's a really good way for clients to understand what their own bodies are doing. So from here, we can go down and lift. And I like to use arms here just to help maintain alignment through the body. So down, lift, and then you can hold it down and just perform the hip extension to the back with the body lean forward slightly. Perform the same exercises on the opposite side. You're going to get some really good quality intensity. So fatigue, I know lots of clients really like. And notice none of this has been done with any weights. It's all just been body weight, which is ideal for people who just can't carry those barbells. You could do this in the park on some steps, very, very simply, very easily. And that's this week's muscle conditioning tip.